YouTube, welcome to my mention today. We have more walkthrough for Endless. I have no clue when and where this series is gonna stop. But for now, we are only gonna go up to Eternatus at floor 250. And I'm just gonna show you how I'm gonna build it with this team. Again, it's gonna be the same strat. We're gonna go for curse and stuff like that. You know, very easy and residual damage with like brute forcing with Gyarados and Cloyster. It's gonna be very close, but you know, that's how Eternatus at 250 is. It's just very close because at this point, we're not really scaling. And I mean, we're gonna look for the mega form on Gyarados, but you know, it is what it is. Luck is what it is. So again, thank you guys for watching this series. Give it a like, you know, subscribe to the channel as well. That would be pretty cool. And let me know what you want to see next. I'm gonna start a new series in a couple of days and we're gonna talk about it. And for the doc, by the way, I am pretty close to finishing it, but I don't know if I'm gonna release it yet. I still have some like stuff to do with tier list, etc, etc. So yeah, that's gonna be it for me. Thank you guys for watching and yeah, have fun. Ah, wrong save. All right, we're back today. I don't know where we're gonna stop or when. What I know is we are definitely going to go past 250. We are probably gonna go to 250 and see how we can deal with it. We have still no money. We have nothing. So there is nothing, no change here. We are still gonna go for lures. We want to keep that that EXP, right? Want to stay on top of it. I'm minus one now. I'm actually, what? Wait, why? Why am I? Okay, whatever. All right, so candies. Wait, we have no candy jars. That's crazy. All right. I hate Fortress as well. It's gonna be a long fight. Yay! Remember, very important to keep like close to the level cap. That's the best way to go about it. We are gonna go and play Duel Battle as we used to. So we're just gonna do... I guess we can Waterfall and Water Shuriken. There you go, we can finish. Just focus on one and later on we'll focus on the both of them. Or, you know, one for each, basically. We just want to kill at least one so we don't take too much damage. We have nothing to heal, so we need to be careful here. Zinc is good. I'm gonna go for it on my Gyarados. We need to start stacking those items. Wow, Zefstrika is very, very, very weak, by the way. That's actually crazy. So we are looking for items that are going to give us any kind of, you know, boost on Gyarados. So we are looking for basically stuff like, you know, King's Rock, Multilens, all of that jazz. That's what we want currently. I'm gonna Waterfall you and I'm gonna Water Shuriken you as well. Your Water Shuriken is enough. I'm gonna talk about all the those items that we need because we're gonna be pretty unlucky at the beginning. Mainly because of the luck that we have. It's pretty low. We're still gonna switch all those items and remember to switch and transfer the item that you have on your Zigzagoon, right? You want them to not stay at 10. You want to switch them between your different Pokemons. That's the plan here. I'm still gonna go for lures. Don't really care for the Reviver Seed now. We are not even close to a Paradox Pokemon, so it should be fine. Okay, Candy Jar. Those are the items we need. Candy Jars, King's Rock, Multilens, like Leftovers, you know, Wildlands. All of those big items that we need. Anything besides those like low and bad items. Like Vitamins, X item. I mean, we do need Vitamins. But X items, we don't really need them. Like in the, for example here, X attack is good for killing faster, but Nuggets is way better overall to get like, start stacking the money basically. And see, with all the EXP that we have, we are currently at floor 115 and we have all the level, we are currently at the level floor, the level cap for the floor, sorry. So I could potentially reroll, but that's not worth. I'm just gonna use the the PP max and we should be fine. Alright, we have the first Suldu. So basically, Suldus are just gonna give us more attack and more stats. So you want to go for them on your main Pokémon as soon as you possibly can, because again, they're just gonna boost your stats and it's very, very important. I actually forgot to switch here, so it's pretty bad. I'm still gonna switch because I don't want to die on my Gengar. We want to like avoid losing Pokémons and losing too much health as well. Because like reviving or using potions costs money. Money doesn't really matter at this point. We're not gonna reroll even if we get something good. We can reroll if we have very bad items. We might use the like if we have only potions and X items, we want to reroll. But if we have lures, to be honest, that's just more than enough for what we have currently. We just need the XP. We need to have that level cap every time. We are at 126 and now basically, what we're looking for, we're just looking for candies. You know, just to get those levels against the opponents. So here, for example, we have absolutely nothing. We can't learn anything interesting with Mushroom. All those items are useless. Potion could be useful, but we can spend like a reroll maybe to get a candy or to get something else. In this case, we got nothing, so I'm just gonna use the potion. But you know, you can just reroll. You don't really need to have all that money. You can keep some, you know, for using Hyper Potion when you are gonna close to a boss where you actually want that money. Paradox time, we are gonna heal whatever we need in HP. I'm gonna heal Gengar as well. Just spend that money because if you lose, you have no money anyways. So let's go with X attack. Same strat, we're gonna try. We're going to Gengar, we're gonna curse. We're fine. There you go, we die, that's okay. And now I'm gonna do as much damage as I can with Cloyster. And if I die, I go on Gyarados. That's it. That's literally it. Not bad. Not bad. He's gonna lose even more with Curse. We are on the last bar right now. I'm gonna Intimidate and Waterfall. Okay, there you go. That's it. Those fights are a bit like weird at this point. Because we are missing like the items that we need to do damage. That's why it's very janky right now. But, I mean, it's gonna get better, so. Alright, so against, like, rock types that have Sturdy, potentially, here. And they can one-shot you because, you know, rock against flying. If he's Stone Edge, it's probably gonna kill me because we are the same level or close to. So here I'm gonna go Cloyster and I'm probably gonna kill with Water Shuriken. But we want to get rid of that Sturdy, right? That's what we want to get rid of here. Finally, we have a fire biome. Wow, you know, it's the best for us because we have Rain Dance and we have fire types. It's a pretty rare one, but you know, it's gonna be a very short one, sadly. All right, so candies to get over the cap. Just one shot those fire types. If we get Reshiram now, I'm gonna be mad though. Like if we actually get Reshiram, I'm mad. Okay, good. Thank you. I think I saw Mystic Water. If you have any kind of item that boosts your damage of a specific like type, you want to switch them right now, as soon as you can. There is two Mystic Waters here. So that's 40% on water damage. So it's pretty strong. And again, switch those berries. We have a couple of Ganlon, but I will switch them. We have Black Belt, which is finding that's not it. We still want to switch all of those items later on, but not now. Lansat, there you go. Do we have anything interesting? No. We can switch Lepa on Cloyster, because why not? Take those lures. We really are pretty unlucky on items. It's very interesting, to say the least. Yep. Candy plus potion. We go into Iron Jugulis. So same thing. He might one shot me. He might not one shot me. That's fine. Okay, he's gonna kill me. That's okay. Later on, we want to have a plan for this, especially for Eternatus. But for now, it doesn't matter. I'm gonna deal some damage with the Icicle Spear. Can definitely deal some damage here. Cloyster is pretty strong against flying type. We are gonna die, but that's okay. Because we are just close to the next floor anyways. There you go, and now we just ice spin on this guy. And GG. Alright. The road to Eternatus now. So for Eternatus, we actually need a plan. Which is not really complicated, to be honest. It's gonna be the same for those guys here. We are just gonna curse. Move on to Cloyster, deal some damage, then move to Gyarados. That's the plan. If I ever see this, I'm actually gonna give it to Gengar, because we're gonna need it for Eternatus. So we want to curse Eternatus whatever happens. We want to have that residual damage going, like Leech Seed, and all of that jazz. So we need those. Alright, Mega Bracelet, we might have the Mega Evolution coming up on Gyarados. That would be pretty cool, to be honest. But you know, I'm not too much in a hurry. Whenever we get it, we get it. That's the goal here. We're gonna be very strong with Mega Evolution too. Alright, time for Eternatus. I know it's been we have been in a in a very boring loop. Actually, it's not even a loop, it's just a boring passage here. Because we got nothing on the shop, nothing interesting, nothing new. So I've been just, you know, spamming battles. Nothing to do here. We're gonna heal. And as I said, we want to have a strat for Eternatus, and the strat is what we said earlier, so. Alright, so Eternatus is gonna be scary. It is what it is. It's always scary at this point. I'm gonna curse into the beam. So now we are gonna go into Cloyster. So the goal is basically to make him use his beams and just go on Pokemon that can make like deal damage. Like the Icicle Spear here is gonna actually deal pretty big damage, right? And now he's gonna have like all those items. So he has a Citrus Berry and he has Enigma Berries. So those two are gonna heal them both. What we do, we're gonna switch into Pokemon that are basically useless. So Zigzagoon. Okay, this time he's actually gonna Sludge Bomb me, he's not gonna beam me. We want the beam to hit because we want him to recharge. Okay, he's just gonna spam the bomb. Okay, sure. I was just dealing damage here with the curse. If I go into Lilligant, he's probably gonna sludge bomb as well. So I'm just gonna go into Cloister. He's gonna bomb too. That's actually pretty bad. I don't know why he's spamming sludge bomb, but that should be fine. He's probably gonna do sludge bomb into Lilligant as well. Yeah, he's just killing everything. I think he's just broken. That's okay, because now he has basically nothing left. Wait, what does he have? He has Enigma Berry. And I'm just going to Waterfall. And Curse should be fine. There you go. So very scary, very, very scary when you have no items. And he wasn't spamming Eternal Beam as well. He was actually spamming Sludge Bomb, which is scary. For 500, we're going to do the same thing, but we're going to have more items. And I'm going to try to bring maybe some sort of protect as well. This way we can abuse the beam. We'll see how this goes, but all right, so that's gonna be it for this episode. We are at 261 now. Again, I'm gonna try to record 1 hour every day and I'm gonna put episodes together. I think this episode was good. The goal was just to go past 250 and fight against Eternatus. It was a pretty scary fight, but it's mainly because he's one faster than me and he has all those bonuses at the end when he's very low health. So it's very scary, but you know, it's still okay. Okay, well, in any case, that's gonna be it for me. So thank you guys for watching and I will see you in the next one. Bye.